Most of us would like to spend our vacations or else leisure time visiting somewhere or having a worthy time with our families. Some would visit countryside, beachside, or else even go abroad. If you're financially able, you can do whatever you like. Traveling abroad seems really nice until the problems such as booking tickets, packing up, getting ready, and boarding luggage arise. Even though these work count a lot of energy, people eagerly prepare themselves with these trivial matters in order to spend their leisure time freely and comfortably. It was the same with Emmett E-Class Walker, who was longing to set himself free from his daily work and spend some valuable time for himself. But he must have never thought that he will have to endure a hard time while getting on the airplane. Let's see what really happened to Emmett and how did he bravely responded to the sudden mishap. Before going, make sure you've subscribed to our channel and hit the bell icon to be notified with our latest updates. Emmett E-Class Walker is an African-American man who engaged himself as an executive music producer. He was a busy man who almost had to sit and work for long hours in the studio. At the start, it was so hard for him, but he paved his path through hard work and perseverance, which he could build up a strong and stable base for his career and a promising future. Time passed and it was nearly his birth date. He thought that he should have a sound rest after all these years working days and nights in the studio. He wanted to relax himself out from his busy schedule, so he planned to fly to Dominican Republic to celebrate his birthday freely and happily. Emmett completed all his workload by overtiming so that he could free his mind before flying. He packed his things, got ready, and bought a first-class air ticket to fly on the day before his birthday, so he could spend his birthday on the next day much leisurely. He went to the Ronald Reagan Washington Airport and waited in the queue early so that nothing could delay his travel. He watched the line shamble forward so slowly that the line was becoming longer and longer. This was the time where Emmett had to encounter with the nasty situation, which he never thought would happen. Excuse me," called a high-pitched voice from behind Emmett, as if someone wanted him to move aside. He turned around and saw a white blonde-haired woman looking at him from head to toes. The woman pointed her chin towards the sign that said the line he was standing in was for reserved first-class flyers. Emmett was baffled that he could not understand what this woman was trying to say. The woman spat out some more words, but he just could not understand what she was up to. "I believe you may be in the wrong place," the woman said to Emmett with a long face. He tried to tell the woman that he was surely flying in the first class cabin, but before he responded, the rude woman yelled at him saying, "Let us through." Emmett was astonished to see the woman yelling at him for no reason. He tried to stay calm and explain the situation, but the temper of this woman was really bad that she did not let him speak. He had to raise his voice so that the matter between them could be resolved. So he told the woman that he was going to fly in the same board as her and he was in the correct line. However, this woman again raised her voice and said to Emmett, "You may be in the wrong place. You need to let us through. This line is for priority booking." He quickly asked the woman, "Priority means first class, right?" And the woman said, "Yes, so get off the line quickly and let us board. Now excuse us, they will let you know you all after we board." Emmett tried to stay calm, as he was still at the airport surrounded by many passengers. Even though the woman was making a rash scene by spitting unnecessary words at him, he tried to find reasons to stay calm. He tried to find excuses for her behavior. He thought that she might have assumed that he could not afford a first-class air ticket. Emmett was really confused. He could not understand why this woman was so cruel and how she was so certain that he was in the wrong line. He could not do anything other than show the woman his air ticket, which clearly mentioned that he was flying in the same board as her, in the first class. He thought that this argument would soon end because he wanted to spend his traveling time peacefully, but it did not end. The woman did not stop pouring poor words to Emmett, where he became really annoyed. She asked and asked him to move, saying that they must be given priority than him. He calmly explained to the woman that he is also going to board in the same plane as them, and he came earlier than them, therefore he will go first. Emmett once thought this woman must be under a lot of stress, or maybe she thought that his dress was not matching first class. After Emmett showed his ticket to the woman, she became outrageous and turned to her friends and said something loudly, making sure Emmett could hear it. "He must be military or something, but we paid for our seats, so he should still have to wait," she mourned passively yet aggressively. Finally, Emmett found out the reason behind the aggressiveness of this woman. She was judging Emmett by his skin color, which he could not believe. In this era, who would judge a man by his skin color? How can someone be that much superficial and treat others like this? Emmett thought. He tried to convince himself by thinking that he might have got a wrong idea about this woman. She might have not thought like that. But just a second after thinking like that, the woman would say something more rude, making Emmett's heart break. Finally, he had to respond to this woman in a way that she will understand. So he turned around and said, "Nope, too big to be in anybody's military." It was true that he had a big physique when compared to normal people, and that was the main reason for him to book a first-class air ticket so that he could enjoy his ride comfortably without harming others. A number of thoughts were racing inside his mind, making him so uncomfortable. Who is she to question him about his tickets? What right has she got to do so? He thought a lot. He knew very well that the woman was trying to belittle him due to his nationality and skin color. Nobody would ever ask him if he worked for the forces because of his large physique. The woman was only being rude to Emmett. At this point, passengers started to gather around and see what all the commotion was. Why did she think that a black man could not afford a first-class air ticket? Why do they always criticize and disparage black people? Emmett's head was full of such thoughts. He had to stand up by himself in order to make an end to this argument. He turned around with a smile on his face, looked straight into the rude woman's eyes and said, "I'm not from any military. I'm just an African-American man with money to afford a first-class air ticket." The woman was agonized and felt guilty by his reaction to her rudeness. The crowds of passengers burst into laughter and clapped Emmett for his bravery. The argument stopped after that and they were able to board, but the story did not end there. Emmett felt horrible after this incident and had to take a step further more in order to let others know about the existence of such impolite people. He secretly took a photo of the blonde-haired woman who abusively talked to him, and while he was flying, he posted it onto his Facebook for his friends to see. He did not know that this will be shared by so many people, and it went viral. Many people commented praising Emmett. Within 2 days after this post was shared more than 250,000 times and hundreds of people commented on behalf of Emmett. Never judge a book by its cover. She is so ignorant, it makes no sense that people like her exist. Handled it well, were some of the comments given by people. He was not happy about this post becoming viral because he only needed to let other people know how to act in front of these people. He did not like to be a topic under racism or else to spread racism. So he made another post and said, "These racist stuff is definitely an issue, but this is not the solution to that issue. It brings me no joy waking up in paradise on my birthday." He thought that it was not nice of him to celebrate his birthday happily while one person was having a hell-like time. Emmett was a chivalrous man with good manners, and he always thought well before acting. He lived a righteous life and put himself in others' shoes before dealing with any problem. His post did not let down thoughts of racism as he thought, but developed vulgarly in between racist people. So he wanted to change the opinion of this post. He made another post and stated in block letters, "I would like to apologize to the woman I had this encounter with yesterday. No matter how wrong your actions, you do not deserve this. I believe if you cannot help nobody, at the very least, you should never do anything to hurt them." Even though Emmett was not at fault, he made this apology because he wanted to cease away any guilt in his heart. But sadly, that woman had not accepted his apology, even though she did not deserve it. Racism is not a religion or a race. It is a belief that brainless people believe in, that one group of people is superior and the minor groups are inferior. Most of all, racism is developed under races, religions, and skin color. Many countries all around the world have gone through racist situations where many innocent people had to suffer. This dark belief must be eradicated from the minds of people before it rises above the level that it cannot be ceased. So that's it for today's video, and we hope you learned some values of being humble and patient. Make sure you've subscribed to our channel and hit that bell icon to be notified with our latest updates. See you soon in our next video.